Good morning, dear students. I hope you all are well and doing your study and enjoying learning. I have wondered, do any of you have pets in your home? Yes. If you have any pets in your home, तो आपने कभी उससे बात करने की कोशिश की है? आपका कभी दिल नहीं करता है कि मतलब वो कभी मुझसे बात करे, मुझे कुछ कहे? करता है, जैसे कि कभी अगर हमारे घर में कैट तो मोस्टली सबके घर में होती, तो कभी दिल करता है ना कि जैसे इंसान से हम बात करते, कभी वो भी हमसे बात करे. बट सैडली एनिमल्स एंड बर्ड्स कांट टॉक, बट आर मूवीज नाउ आर डेज शो अस वॉट इट वुड लुक लाइक इफ दे रियली टॉक. हियर इज अ क्लिप. यू कैन सी ऑल द एनिमल्स talking and singing, sharing what they are feeling. Let's watch.
Gee, Monty, I don't want to rush you, but you really have to leave. The littles are due back any minute, and you know they don't like strange cats in the house.
Not that you're strange.
Hey, Snow, what's wrong with you?
Nothing.
You know, you're the one acting strange. What is it, worms, fleas? Yeah, you look pale.
Eesh.
Maybe you should see a vet.
A vet? What a swell idea. Do you know anybody? I'm not so happy with mine. He makes us wait and his hands are always cold.
What was that?
What was that what?
What was that what?
Huh?
Well, I hate to eat and run.
No, no, please. By all means, run. Run like the wind.
Whoa!
Phew. That was gross.
Hey, Snow, I almost forgot to thank you. Sorry. Okay.
What the?
Oh, no.
Oh, my pants.
Say, they're really putting some wild prizes in there, huh, Monty?
Huh? Oh, hello. You must be a friend of Snowbell's. I'm Stuart.
Aren't you gonna run?
Why?
'Cause you're a mouse?
I'm not just a mouse. I'm also a member of this family.
Oh.
A mouse with a pet cat.
A mouse with a pet cat! I guess that is pretty funny.
Pretty funny? I'm gonna wet my fur! A mouse with a pet cat! Your new little master! Wait till the boys hear about this!
Oh, the humiliation.
I'm gonna kill you!
Oh, dear.
Come back here!
सो स्टूडेंट्स, आपको ये क्लिप देख के मजा आया कि कैसे एनिमल्स आपस में अगर बात करते थे तो कैसे वो लोग बात करते. इजंट इट सो अमेजिंग टू सी दीज एनिमल्स. द पोएम विच इज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टूडे इज समथिंग रिलेटेड टू दिस क्लिप. द पोएट इज लुकिंग एट द बर्ड एंड फिश एंड वंडरिंग वॉट दे आर थिंकिंग. सो today we will be studying and appreciating the poem A Lark. We'll understand the central ideas and values of this poem by Lawrence Alma Tadema. You must be wondered, who is Alma Tadema? Lawrence Alma Tadema was a daughter of a very famous painter. She was born in Brazil in 1865. She loved concerts. That is why she began writing books, short stories, plays and poetries. Here I have mentioned some books which she had written, her work. Number 1, The Divine Orbit. Number 2, A Gleaner's Sheaf Verses. Number 3, Songs of Womanhood. Now students, let's read the whole poem and understand it, what she is talking about. You can follow along with words and the screen. lark bird soaring high, are you never weary? When you reach the empty sky, are the clouds not dreary? Don't you sometimes long to be a silent goldfish in the sea? Now, students, can you tell me what is mean by soaring? Soaring means flying or rising high in the sky. Matlab, bahut zyada sky ke upar udna. Weary means very tired. Here, the poet asks the lark, which is flying high in the sky, whether it is never tired or exhausted. He asks if it doesn't find the clouds very boring in the empty sky. The poet wonders if it doesn't sometimes wish to be a silent goldfish in the sea. Now, students, let's move ahead and read the second stanza. Goldfish, goldfish, diving deep, are you never sad, say? When you feel the cold waves creep. Now, students, what do you mean by creep? Creep means move slowly and quickly. Are you really glad, say? Don't you sometimes long to sing and be a lark on the wings? Now, again, a poet talks with a goldfish. He talks to the goldfish diving deep into the sea. Is the goldfish never sad? मतलब वो जब एकदम गहराई में जाती है तो क्या उसको उदास नहीं होती है? It is really happy when it feels the cold waves creeping towards it. Cold waves मतलब ठंडी. Waves का मतलब क्या होता है? लहरे. He wonders if it doesn't sometimes long to sing like lark in flight. Now, students, the main theme of this poem is that the poet feels that the both a lark in the sky and a goldfish in the sea are not happy, that they are lonely, which means we have learned in this poem that जो भी हमको गॉड ने दिया है हमको उसी में खुश रहना चाहिए. For example, अगर लार्क जो बर्ड है अगर हम उसको पानी में छोड़ देंगे तो क्या वो जिंदा रहेगी? नहीं, वो मर जाएगी, क्योंकि उसको गॉड ने उड़ने के लिए बनाया है. इसी तरह अगर फिश को हम पानी से निकाल देंगे तो वो पानी के बिना जिंदा नहीं रह सकती. इसलिए हमारे पास जो भी है, अगर हम किसी के बहुत ज़्यादा टॉयज देखते हैं, किसी के पास कुछ खिलौने देखते हैं, तो हमको अफसोस नहीं करना चाहिए, बल्कि हमको गॉड को थैंक यू करना चाहिए कि हम को गॉड ने जिस हालत में रखा है, जैसा रखा है, हम बहुत अच्छे हैं. नाउ चिल्ड्रेन, सो इन दिस शॉर्ट पोयम देयर आर सम राइमिंग वर्ड्स. डू यू नो व्हाट्स राइमिंग आर? अ राइमिंग वर्ड इज अ रिपीटेशन ऑफ सिमिलर साउंड्स इन वर्ड्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, call, mall, me, tea, lime, rhyme, like. So in this poem there are certain rhyming words are given. So students, let underline it. In the first stanza, underline the rhyming words. Here in first stanza, the rhyming words are high, sky, very, teary, B, C. Students, I have underlined different color. You can see in the slide. Now, students, let's next move in the next stanza. Deep, creep, say, say, sing, wings. A rhyming words. इनको कहते हैं, ओके स्टूडेंट्स. राइमिंग वर्ड्स में क्या होता है, साउंड जो होता है सिमिलर होता है, और स्पेलिंग्स डिफरेंट होगी तो चलेगा, मगर साउंड्स जो होना चाहिए वो क्या होता है, ऑलवेज सेम होता है. रिपीटेशन ऑफ साउंड, It's called rhyming words. So students, I hope you have understood this short poem, which is written by Lawrence Alma Tadema. Students, please complete your notes and start learning.